Leasing a car comes with a bunch of different restrictions that are not even also obvious to a lot of people. What I want to talk about in this video is 10 different things you can't do in your auto lease that you will actually get penalized for from the lease company if they find out. What is happening, guys? Ari here from Boston Automotive Consulting. And in the description below, you're going to find multiple resources to help you navigate not only getting the very best deal on a brand new car, but you'll be able to check out insurance rates as well as get your auto credit scores. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing because this whole channel is going to teach you everything you're going to need to know so that you can negotiate your best possible deal. Now, I'm going to give you 10 and I'm going to be very, very quick. I'm not one of those people that likes to talk about nonsense exactly like how I'm doing right now. Number one, you cannot repair body parts with non-OEM body parts or replace mechanical parts with non-genuine components. This is very, very much the case with, say, Mercedes-Benz, where some of their cars, some of the mechanical components of their cars have particular sensors on them. They're wear sensors, they're indicators, and you can't replace them with, say, a cheaper component. And what this does is that this actually voids the warranty on the Benz. The warranty on the car is issued by a company completely separate than the person that's leasing out the car. So the lease company doesn't want to be put in a situation where their warranty on their car has become void. This will result in a penalty equal to the amount that's being voided. Number two, you can't replace the tires with a mismatched set. You can't have, say, on the left side of the car, a Bridgestone all season, and on the right side, you got a Michelin summer tire. The car has gotta be returned back with the correct set of tires on the left and right side front and the left and right side rear. They can be mismatched on the particular halves on the car, but they can't be mismatched on the sides. I don't know who created this rule, but you gotta have them match on the front and you gotta have them match on the back. You will actually be charged for those sets of tires that are not the correct pair. Number three, you can't use the car in any car sharing or taxi service that also, in many cases, will include DoorDash, you guys. I'm seeing a lot of comments asking for, you know, can I use the car for Uber, Lyft? Can I use it for DoorDash? And a lot of companies are coming out and saying you cannot use the car for any sort of car sharing or taxi service. They have not begun to get very, very clear on can you use the car for food delivery. So maybe that's also coming next. Number four, you can't take the car out of the country. And if it's Canada, you can't take it out of the country for 30 days or longer. The idea behind this is that let's say you took your leased car and you're in California and you said, hey, why not? Let's go to Tijuana. Guess what? You can't take your leased car, and in a lot of circumstances, border guards will ask you if you're in a leased car, and if that's the case, you gotta turn your butt around. If you're going to Canada, a lot of the times, if you're there for longer than 30 days, you got a ticket or you got some sort of parking fine or whatever, and they sent the bill to the lease company, they will begin to track whether or not you've been in the country for longer than 30 days on a subsequent notice. You got to take this seriously because car manufacturers have become increasingly wary of vehicles leaving the country for export reasons. This is a big business outside of the control of some of these lease companies. All of a sudden their car is missing and the lessee is also missing. So it's become a very, very big problem. Number five, you can't buy the vehicle for less than the residual or the buyout price of the car. A lot of people think that at the end of the lease, they can just negotiate the buyout price. This is not the case. The buyout price is very, very much like a credit card balance, where if you choose that you're gonna try and negotiate your credit card balance, they don't really care and they're gonna continue asking for the amount that you agreed to pay because you spent that much money or you agreed to pay that money at the end or turn in the car. They're gonna list it on your credit report if you don't decide to pay it or turn in the car. Number six, you can't let anyone but your spouse drive the car. This is clearly listed out in your lease contract. Now, I don't think that this is the biggest deal in the world. I don't think you'll get penalized for it. However, this is listed out in the contract, and it says it very, very clearly that you or your spouse are the only people allowed to drive the car. I don't know exactly what the enforcement is like, but that's a rule. Number seven, something that a lot of my friends are constantly asking me about. You cannot modify engine, exhaust, computer, hard body panels, like the quarter panels. You can't do any of the big modifications like some of my friends like to do on their cars without the lease company sending you a bill for the whole balance of the car. There's been many situations where a car has gone to the dealership, they found out about the engine computer being modified, and the lease company just sent them a bill for the whole car. You can't modify the car, especially when it comes down to engine control modules, computers, ECUs, things like this, because it generally creates a situation where the car is no longer quote unquote good in the next buyer's eyes. It loses a lot of value this way. Number eight, if they find out that you've been street racing or even just participating in a track event of any sort, autocross, anything like that, they will send you a bill and the car will be completely yours. So don't go to your next autocross track event and post something to Instagram, because if the lease company finds out, they will send you a bill for the complete buyout value for your car. Number nine, you cannot miss a couple lease payments without letting them know, because guess what? They will show up to your house with a tow truck and repossess the car. They don't want to waste any time in repossessing it, because that's only going to delay them selling the car at auction and recuperating their loss from the whole thing. And if you don't let them know, it's a big no-no. Let them know if you're going to miss lease payments at the very first sign that you're going to miss a lease payment, because it will create a big issue. And lastly, number 10, you can't just turn in the car early and expect to get out of the bill. It's not like renting a house and breaking the lease where you tell the landlord, yeah, screw you, try and find me to collect your money, or like, oh, hey, yeah, keep the security deposit. It doesn't work like that. The lease companies are generally like credit card companies. They will list it on your credit report, and it will get in the way of you trying to get another auto lease, not even from that brand, just generally. It will get in the way in the future. I spent a lot of time, you guys, going through a few different lease contracts to come up with the list of things on the lease contract that they tell you not to do. And I really, really do hope that this gave you a clearer picture as to what is actually really even being stated in these auto lease contracts, what they're gonna charge you for if you decide that you're gonna violate, etc. I wanna encourage you to visit the links in the description below to shop around for not only the best new car deal, but check out insurance rates as well as get your auto credit scores. If you found this information useful, please consider subscribing. Thank you so much for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.